through the basic message of graffiti remains the same to keep around the private as a commentary on the private control and public and use of public space on graffiti has been used to type of political resistance to the world nations in Paraguay. Graffiti has been a critical medium by which communication occurs. Graffiti writing is one of the easiest and most efficient ways for individuals and opposing groups to register their political dissidents and establish an alternative collective member. Graffiti, if recognized by groups and organized sufficiently, is an important medium for breaking down the dominant control and censorship which authoritarian governments exercise. Graffiti may be understood as a discourse of anti-structure, a passive resistance to structural complacency to the elite's dictation of public speech. Graffiti challenges core ethics to our culture without actively posing a threat to dominant ideology. The writing on the walls, like poetry, sentiments about the culture, system, put forth in society through their passive nature, implicitly questions of societal norms. This type of passive resistance gives a minority within a culture a voice. And graffiti is not armchair politics. It's a powerful force against the hegemonic processes of the status quo, which marginalize and drowns out minority voices. That's Giller in 97. Marginalized groups have been systematically denied the power of self-expression due to which the image provides. Graffiti becomes a successful a hegemonic strategy used by a marginalized culture to establish a voice. The result is the elitism of high culture. Minorities are denied access to cultural production and distribution. The result of the elite control and the formation of social norms meeting acknowledges as coordinated groups become defined in relation to the dominant voice. It's an exclusionary system. The experiencing the lives of the other is not a choice for marginalized groups. The art can serve as a source of identity and empowerment. Art is able to give a voice and empower those who have been silenced. Art becomes a powerful way to stimulate social change and formulate identity with the power of affect and social norms becomes a new power to create legitimate subjectivity, new definitions, new value, new history, new memories. Once that power is reached, identity can be self-determined, self-denied. In the 1970s, the development of graffiti art in New York City became African-American and Puerto Rican urban youth. The power to transform the urban space of identity and signs of empowerment. Graffiti is the best response provided by people denied a response. And Josh and I affirm graffiti as investment in transportation infrastructure. Specifically, affirm the choices within your agency. Slave morality is founded on an obsession with transcendence, focusing on something far removed from our powers as a means to escape the status quo, creating an ontological condition of life denial. Graffiti is possible for all of us, and historically has been a means of communication and empowerment for even the most oppressed peoples. Affirming this agency is key to unlock the potential for life. Smith, 10. Discussion with a model of the ideal resistance small group organization with generally preempted by an argument about intention was a group for the potential for a convenient tactic turned suddenly to a new strategic and then sometimes spotted early if stumped out, so rather than such and seek a model for group structure is most likely to achieve by proposed or resistant go for disruptive qualities with the attention whirling around these international situations trips given the benefit of the small group practices and deferral to ends including the deferral for discussing the ends as long as possible until the process cannot sustain itself as it accelerates with similarly a drifting group bounces back and forth between positions that the course of a single drift draw opportunistically from different theories that are required to disrupt the tendency of the creative action to follow course of least resistance finds its way too quickly to an outcome territorialization can be suspended to allow for more and more laying of activities one upon another play within the vandalism upon mapping and sculpting until a group can't grasp somewhere unexpected and uncontainable. There are more theories that are superimposed in a given zone. Circulation between them is harder for the power to get to get a handle on them. The greater likelihood of outcomes becomes uncontainable for those who seek to control them. More importantly, for those who seek to create them, is by such creators as some of the most effective policing of geographic powers carried out. We are not the starting point because we are always already cast into the middle. We must begin politics with the question, what can we do now? History is always written from a sedimentary point of view, but in reality, life is dynamic and ever-changing. So too must be our politics. What we needed more than ever is ruptures against the dominating modes of politics which characterize the status quo, play with ideology, refuse calcification, and write with slogans. That's Deleuze and Guattari in 80. History is always written from a sedentary point of view, and the name of the unitary state apparatus, even when the topic is nomads, when it's lacking the opposite of history, writing webs of war machine and lines of why the culture book is necessarily being tracing already, tracing into the self-tracing the previous book by the same author, and endless tracing of established concepts of work, especially in the realm of memory, any precarious and pragmatic framework for tracing the concepts as imperceptible by rupture, not signifying great history, has never comprehended nomadism, the book has never comprehended the outside, the war machine's relationship to the outside is not another model for the assemblage that makes itself nomadic in the books, writing part of every mobile machine, the stem of the resum to write with slogans, make resums, not roots, never plan. Don't be one, be multiple, be multiplicities. Have short-term ideas, make maps, not photos or drawings. Resum has no beginning or end, is always in the middle. Where are you coming from? What are you heading for? These are totally useless questions, making clean slates, seeing the beginning of foundation is all in play. False conception of voyage and move.
First part talks about how graffiti contributes to our understanding of culture around transportation infrastructure.
Yeah.
How do we know what is considered cultural?
We say that cultural is partially up to that of the graffiti artist. We say that graffiti is a message that spreads cultural ideas, people's personal beliefs, and that that expression helps us understand things about the world.
Okay, so yeah, so expression, that gets to another question I had. It says, quote, graffiti is the voice of the common man.
Mm-hmm.
What does that mean?
Our argument is just that graffiti is an accessible political tactic that people can use to express their voice.
Okay, how can graffiti express the voice of anyone other than the person who did the act of graffitiing?
Our argument is that since anyone can do the act of graffiti, then it would express the voice of those who use it. Also, some people have common cultural beliefs. If a graffiti artist were to depict one of those beliefs, a person or being seeing that could agree with it and say that that also expresses my culture,
fair
my
enough.
Beliefs.
Arguing a bit in the vein of an inherency-esque argument, what are the restrictions on graffiti in this?
Well, first we would say that more graffiti is always good.
Okay.
There doesn't necessarily have to be a restriction, but our second piece of Fraser and Spalding evidence indicates that transportation in the status quo, you could say, is used for teleologically used for utility, that people don't see it as a site for individual empowerment and expression. Rather,
okay.
It's a form of utility. We say that.
So here's my question.
That.
The object of the transportation infrastructure is being teleologically used for utility.
Yep.
The 1AC takes an obvious stance against. What does graffiti add to that transportation infrastructure that is beneficial? What do you bring to the table of the TI?
We say that that's probably subjective. Individuals using graffiti to express themselves on transportation infrastructure gives people, one, a voice that we say that should be affirmed, and two, it's a cultural expression. We say that using things through the lens of a telos, seeing them as only calculable through a lens of utility, reduces the ability for individuals to express themselves, and we think individual expression is good.
Okay, is graffiti a form of art?
Yes, we would say so, probably.
Okay, and how do you, like, determine that? Your evidence seems to sort of say that there's, like, a debate in the literature about whether or not it is.
Well,
why do you say that it is?
We leave that up to the people writing graffiti. If they view their work as art, then we allow them to affirm that art.
Okay. The final, or one of the cards in the 1AC is about affirming the agency that you have.
Yes.
What is agency all about?
Our argument is that agency is the ability to have a voice via a performance and method.
Okay.
When you can perform a political methodology, then you are able to have a voice, and graffiti offers a medium for that.
All right, thanks.
The order is three off in case.
Okay.
Do you want me to speak from over there so I can flip the cards to you?
Either way, we can probably just come get the cards if you.
Okay. Otherwise, I'll be speaking from like my end of the table.
Okay.
So
yeah. Then I'll just
card.
Move over to play. Yeah. You can speak.
Cool.
Three off in case.
Yep, three off in case.
It's all paper.
Yep.
Okay.
Is anyone not ready? John, are you? Oh, you're getting paper.
I'm good. I'm just getting flow paper.
Okay.
First off, this framework, our interpretation is that the firm must present that hypothetical and defend the hypothetical implication of the United States substantially increasing its transportation infrastructure investing in the United States, and resolve it provides a framework for resolution to enact the policy words in 364, definition of withdrawal to resolve it as definition to enact the meaning satisfied by law, and the USFG should meet the fact that it's only about the outcome of policy satisfied by federal means, Erickson 3, each subject contains the agent doing to be the agent as part of its means to annual policy through government and police interrogation, is by something that must be granted, and the USFG is governed in Washington, D.C. in current 2K, within the U.S. of Washington, D.C., and investment. Infrastructure is physical spending through physical assets and not graffiti using an IND. The investment in infrastructure is capital spending, transportation capital spending, investment in physical capital infrastructure, relevant technical programs, and are violation of the resolution as their individual investment in graffiti without a policy. And you should vote next. First topic, the independent resolution, which is voting for recommended equity and jurisdictional integrity, and two, register for their framework laws for infinite, non-possible, unbreakable, totalizing personal terms of nature, and possibly negative, and three, switch time to make spending every round of the arrest. about your case unproductive, you not know both sides of the argument. If you read, you lose on both sides, and four, go off to you can read this argument with your negative. To win this round, you need to prove why reading this happened, being not topical is good. And five, topicality, four, apathy, vote negative, and say they're not topical, not that you don't believe in their and their criticism. And rather, this is a priority issue. Chiefly, 2A, we must recognize the role of government people in the constant our agreements that are highly appropriate and starting conditions of debate. We cannot agree with something, we cannot agree about that. The openness that we must agree about what is being debated before we can debate. Next off is object oriented ontology. All for the affirmative, their world is a textual object full of signifiers, narratives, and discourses. This creates a focus on how human subjects relate to the world and renders the objects invisible, right? And to all cultural subjects are dominated by the focus on discursive. We're able to talk about science, narrative, discourse, and ideology within the federation text of the decoded. There is no non discursive power things. There is nothing about ideology. These things are on the radio for those theorists. We don't talk about it. We don't notice it. We get a notice of difference with humans. Our contributing difference between humans and neutral legislature versus lack of blinks between human intention and language difference in science. And we do not have an alternative in the force of mandating action, but rather a different lens to view the world. A flat ontology which holds all objects and that they equally exist in brain and intent. Flat ontology is a conventional ontology familiar with a different ontology perspective. Individual being the ones that are entirely individual. Flat ontology is a conventional all things are object different because they're object for different reasons. Ontology refuses to be mandated. Object and flat ontology vigor reinvent every invention of reflections that are called rocks. Can use atomic particle and free object is reproduced along the stone right object. Atoms are within the rubber and our rockets and generate a flat ontology reproduced and the railing of all others. And a flat ontology plays the world of all objects. The most open form of ethics and solves extinction right in 12. Turning attention to objects in the most running blood different ever different forms of generosity other than human trees and rocks and dogs that are super crazy and impressively about our independent about every absolutely everything about love world that all person have the object in all the different ways. Oh, it's a great political and ethical philosophy has been obliged non-human that are focusing on only scripture ethical condition, a collective survival and defense of writing ethical decisions which change our relationship to non-humans. And finally, when the critique is a huge cake shirt, our real change only comes from engaging material world of objects, not the academic world of textual discourse focus, not all objects is open to solve the affair right in 12. What is political theory claims not represent the world but change in that never saved academic journals deep so academic fields reproduce itself and only our articles are designated to demolish capital and quality of all point where we only talk about the system function only addressing other academics our child requires different also go with comprehensive with a different board of change talk about different form of alibi the academic credit change more than right well don't know dominating different form of change change the world rather than maintaining the clause and oh we break it from the question of political theory universal multi giving of course all the more wonder than a hybrid logic or not border with a material list every high project or press different branch of politics within political theory, ideology, discourse, narrative, and according to the art of our mission with critical progressive and political engagement, it was not clear what the difference is about. We were making in front of Wall Street. I yelled, make this awkward by the high world, rock board, the areas. If you really appreciate social change, you're going to require hard attacks and anger, and this word, less critique and cultural audit and ideologies. You must choose your targets more carefully. And next off is the criticism, or the affirmative distances themselves from the real world within the academic question. Revolution is not writing it as a revolution happens at the end of the gun barrel. The negative is passing out rifles. The honorable chairman Mao Zedong in 1927, the accusation within the way back forward. And there are different characters within that way within a charge of these characters. Part of private of the right to speak. And here is a Yan Yan. When talking about the President Association, we have different charges. Say, oh, who is your filthy man? The President brought many lengths. We'll start talking about seeking administration, but they are sure and flattering that they're mere trash and the class of times in the corner of the show of realism, revolution, not marvelous, not terrible. And all the terrors and evil, obviously, the theory of preserving that are revolutionary, the revolutionary. It's obviously the kind of revolutionary theory of talking about revolution point in the South, the human man, not be thrilled, let's roll the sport and present our smashed through danger, and then people swarm into the slaughter, out of slaughterhouse of big human action, but the real little towers have driven into defenses of this. Revolution is not dead, or is not we're writing it as a or painting picture. It cannot be offered jokingly, literally, or temporarily, or courteously. A revolution is violent. Oh, they just talk about peasants going far, humbles and answers of later from those customs. That's just such a reproves a revolution that we must firmly promote. And their lusts, criticism, taxes, in a march of our freedoms are limited. There is no authentic freedom to act. Only the action of our alternative solves Lenin in 1902. Freedom of criticism is the slogan of the present time. The criticism has been a political platform of the university chairs and the French Joseph have become theories much and not that freedom of criticism must maybe freedom of war, freedom of movement, which ideas and social freedom. Is random one under the creature theory and red twenty words and or connected the freedom of criticism. It's only false that we're already mentioning the difference between the different energy and then fighting on retreated within the margin. We were talking about several opposites right out there into the margin. Oh yes, you're free to go into the margin. We're not talking about the primary facts of no search the world of freedom. We are free to we are free to fight and now in case. The apps process has been co-opted by capitalism and sold back to us by the intellectual elite held in 95. Intellectual nomadism bears unprecedented popularization of romantic individualization first and the falsification of been triple by democratic accessible and intellectual and think about the nomadic thinking about legitimizing itself from the world and ideas nomadic is a dramatic or than suited the flight of the ideals and the affirmative is merely painting on structures of oppression that didn't do anything to actually break down structures that commodify society and PG use a Eurocentric model. Israel proves that their method gets co-opted by coloniality. Violence becomes naturalized in their world. Weissman and Six. Pilsen wanted to more popular with the Israeli military. Several ideas and methods and politics were interrupted for us in a problem. We're more popular in terms of suing out of space when we talk about the operation of the power of the Palestinian areas could be thought astriated. The idea of understood the urban fight of spatial problem that traveling through walls and mechanical solution constitute a theory practice that simply takes no combat. Combat become citizens and critical theories important for teaching training theory. It's important for us to articulate the gap between existing maritime and where we want to go and how to become able to train and sometimes kill education and important sometimes in the wide appropriate review of imperialism and education word technology discourse and it becomes a war air wars road and exciting war violence can be run as a total of public support and the idea of development and dissemination of military technology for the fiction of being corrupted in the public mind as a military solution as possible in what situation is hard to very doubtful and the app dooms us to oppression and racism before I refusing to tie yourself to the one he sees oppression is key to liberation from colonialism Magolo and seven the epicenter of individualism with an African and political and epic view when you prosecute our decolonial subject are within the control of Afrocentric and political theory and political lobby and different cases within human existence and different political purposes with an identity politics and the Afro-results in depression and genocide poll but proves in Barbara in 98 those who want to be through to join in the against rocket and the city would be broken out within the rise of the democratic ideal of giving money would reverb an element of freedom would need desire for control of poll but try to create a rural utopia within the economic subsequent employed the regime and broken the fears first the application of Marxism and tyranny resulted in genocide the line of flight is a solid led to poll but and the Lucian Christian excludes woman kills only and there's a reason to vote negative 1984 woman is a remains an existing minority man becomes a subject of becoming even if he is a woman woman's not a woman becoming a man is an example subject of for different DNG a woman must become woman to upcoming woman to do variation woman to become obsolete headless desireless and surfaceless metamorphosis and the app can't happen without massively clearing away all remnants of transcendence that turns case ration 4 delusion quantity rock for attacks to eminence within transcendence and eminence of land of eminence describes the absolute and infinite all of these images are going to be elucidated demonstrated logically and correctly empirically accurate only our friends can accept the plan of eminence which will give you a way we can control the endless life within clearing through all philosophy from ideals and different philosophy of philosophy revolutionary mystery war against enemy radical agreements and only limiting the different hierarchies and knowledge and suiting hierarchical relations with different terms of eminence of philosophy within revolutionary warfare.
Okay, first I'd like to talk about the case debate. Why does using graffiti as a mode of expression get co-opted by things like colonialism and militarism in Egypt?
It's the way you implement it. By implementing it as a form, like through Deleuzean criticism, I forget the author tag offhand, but it indicates that refusing the clearly the stratified forms of control that exist within things like transportation systems justify the state then using those
right.
systems.
But if we just advocate using graffiti as a mode of expression, why does that mean that since the Israeli military was a misreading of Deleuze, that the AF gets co-opted by militarism?
I
just don't see
the point.
The AF doesn't do anything to get rid of militarism, so at best you give a new strategy
so
of nomadism.
It's like linear, then?
I don't think we need to win a brink impact to militarism and colonialism.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
It's the fact that you allow the state to use these structures to continue.
Let's talk about the argument. What's the link to this Bryan evidence? It seems to just indicate that focusing on discourse and materiality instead of materiality leads to things like anthropocentrism, eliminates flat ontology. How is graffiti not a material action?
We will argue that you have represented graffiti as a space of expression, as a space of the way that humans communicate their intent, their meaning, and while it is not a literal words and textual discourse necessarily, it is undoubtedly a form of
expression.
It's
not the reading of the 1AC a focus of humanist discourse.
The 1AC?
The 1NC. You read the 1NC through a discursive medium. Your argument
well, I think
is
that,
that
I think that debate is going to be a wash because we both read with words.
Yeah,
but
so I'm asking, why does discourse necessarily... Okay, what is the impact to, this link argument? The impact of the criticism?
The impact of the criticism is that it creates hierarchical structures of ontology.
How does using graffiti create a hierarchical structure of ontology?
Because it prioritizes human expression.
Why can't animals do graffiti?
I don't know. That
like
a 2AC argument.
Okay.
Also,
so
the critique is not about animals necessarily.
Why
necessarily?
Can't
it's also about objects.
Okay. Cool. Capke, or the Mauke.
Yeah.
Is there an alternative?
Yeah, it's expression through violence, right?
Expression through
just
violence.
Yeah, violence.
Okay. I guess why is that exclusive with the 1AC?
Well, your 1AC is like you don't include violent expression, and you say that we should work to combat structure of oppression just by painting on transportation systems and this passive approach. Our Mao evidence is pretty good in saying that when we merely step back and use forms of aesthetic expression in a situation where we should use violence,
okay.
Then that.
Can we ask one question? Like, when the rev happens, who do you, like, go to war against, I guess? Like, who does the rev lash out against?
Probably capitalists.
Okay. Okay.
Where's the build a flash drive?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we do.
Okay.
Smart board, whiteboard.
Josh, can I ask?
Thought about the similarities in the names of our schools.
Yes, I was like, Stephen A. McClatchy, can you bring that to the
room?
Alright, the order?
Do you need this?
No. It's going to be case, framework, now, IOO.
Okay. Keenan's getting it up and then we'll be ready.
Cool. I'm good. Yeah.
Is it just Byrd case?
It should be.
2AC round 1, 2AC.
Yeah.
Okay.
Are you good?
Yes.
Okay.
We turn our first order of operations while the enemy syndicate is tactical transportation planning, guns, urban space for maximum efficiency, order and exercise of control. Look, I practice the stay push out, sweet space, and here was straight space. Can be easily can controlling dealt with me throwing graffiti as enemies and no matter politics of the individual, which is able to disrupt the tradition, turn an environment to violence, utilitarian purposes, and terms of capital into a support for, or into a place for politics, and then something individual, their culture of capitalism, or their argument, first argument is intrinsic to evil. When I see our biological identity, our form of graffiti is inherently anti-capitalist, which is also a million turn of the Mao argument. This gets commodified to decide. This is also is intrinsic to the one you see. This is our way of we only have to win. Graffiti is from a nomadic politics of the individual, which is a way to express oneself is a good is a good form. They say it's co-opted by the military. I don't really understand how this argument is contextualized from the one you see. Our form of nomadic politics is able to disrupt this because it is inherently opposition to the sort of positions of interiority of the state apparatus. Just like the song, they say it uses racism, but because you refuse to tie yourself, we are interested in your advocacy. Our reading of the one you see, was it as why we tie ourselves to this. Also, we would probably turn this argument with our extended government evidence, which means we give people, we give minorities a voice and a way to express themselves in society, no matter, and a way for them to define themselves, no matter how society defines them. Their next argument is in the context of line of flight. We don't link to that. I dare you find a sentence that says line of flight. You want to see this? And the next argument is that excludes women. This is just, this is not unique. This is a description of the SASCO. Across my mind, a link analysis from above. We give people, like women and minorities, a voice in art. They say, they speak to clear forms of transcendence. The one you see was a form of politics. It was in opposition to more transcendent politics. The SASCO quo that tries to inflict upon us extend. Smith evidence says that this form of politics leads from slave ontology because we never affect state change in the way it's intended to. So this impact of the DNG evidence, which says the SASCO is hierarchized by form of microfascism. This says we can do nothing to change the world before we even try. You need to get on, you need to write a letter to Congress. I mean, these try to convince us. We can't be political without engaging the state. This convinces us. We have no agency ever change. We should affirm our politics and agency on two framework. The one is the impact of the exclusionary practice forever playing the game of politics necessitates exclusion of certain voices, and this makes their form of politics ontological. The world values to vote, or the investment push on the shadow of change agency and shared dogs to debate, or factors true knowledge comes about from changing solutions, from changing the questions asked. Our departure from the resolution is key to one's basis for yet unheard voices. This also answer, your shockly evidence that's calmly in two kids in. You're just shared topic, which is going to be used with something to debate. Rather than answer the question most, the question said, I said, no foreign house, go to talk, there's no particular solutions that are only due to norms. If you're not allowed to invent your own questions, you have actually said, it is a reinforcement of pre existing problems. Or is it going to falsely be sent as kids of seeking seals at senior later beach? No more bound between generic substances or community processes. If you want to carry eminence into a woman, individual verbal exchanges or combinations of animal domains, who is an abstraction that's handled the evidence within the board? Who are the lines connected to the conversation? So the obligation to talk one with the search can take a while line fight, consisting of less than the major language. Is that how people would express themselves, but providing little gaps of solitude in which they wish they can find something? You can say, extend the GG and extend the GG guide evidence. Is your turn to the politics results from the method of debate? Even if their model vaguely activism with vehemently visible and rubber stamped by the state, which leads to all the co-option arguments on the case with this prevention transport of politics, because we're always already beholden to the state, and response wants to set their only warmth about these to punish us, or get a perfect vision to debate who have won unpredictably. All this breeds a hatred of the world, as it's because by luck they're never satisfied with debate as such, but they don't care for not fitting into an ideal preconceived notion of how to win a lot of this also means they produce enough entire knowledge bases, which are against the mental restrictions which are only seen patterns, and extends Smith's thing, turns their recession with the least state changing framework across my analysis from case, and turn out their identification of changes in 30, really gets masses to the degree of marginalized, where some power faced final emissions offered in 96, or also changes in 30 within this, but there's no wish to outcome some of the authority, so much of the case includes my hair, also potential for emancipation, chaos and those virtual opportunity and false chaos, there was a change in our understanding of the community and authority, you can make out this group of use of our to manage that chaos, and fairness is contingent and constantly evolving, there's new value, you can accept books like Johnson 96, where we begin to start playing Berkeley Wilson, and the wall, games are unconscious, like expression of particular decisive particularity, but at a particular historical moment, who looks often to start contingent on historical reasons, people want to be better if they accept the games, world fictions, nothing to do with reality, I believe the recreational complex, there's no mystical belief, we look at the history of games, we discover some progressive evolution. There was some higher type of books are have no permanent status and no claim to privilege access. One of the theory debate will multiple rounds solve their education wins. The debate is no room for macro and micro discussions. And we've already heard the one you see, which makes them uniqueness to the homes and guard armies. And it would have been better for the educated learning agents in some sense of the app. And the false visibility loss of some particularly is good increased critical thinking. This makes anyone know that the protocol agenda was teaching American degree of social media opportunities. Protocol agenda is going to be able to use a lot of interviews in hand. Which will be the results in unique with the new way of serving with virtual reality. They didn't. Or cross-gate different understanding your tools and organization is an experiment. Or also in the process of finding out what works and what doesn't. And this complicates the research of predictability arguments. They're only research, but they're expecting to obviously anything unpredictable or hamstring their ability to engage in this voting absence person. The debaters should be ready for a variety of different aspects. They say we cannot test, but these testing ideas and never begs the question. We agree they have grounded means there are many ways they could test one AC. And this is which I have a clear on, which had to be false or offense is green. Hey, so far, two of this might have a couple of pages, so the question will be another position.
vision. Is anyone within engage with modernity? We will hold the same actors, but without like, human chemistry or size, as we still have full legitimacy. A debate will be seen as a game of power rather than a power rather than the method of democracy. And also, the effects until they say investment is spending, but if we want more impact turns to save best action, a hard form of investment is not one of spending time and effort, because that's the only thing within your LO, that's the only thing you can do within your agency on your own. One per the alternative loop link to the afternoon, in turn critiques capitalism, all existence fell by acts of rising politics, unique link turn, capitalism is not an external force that alternative bills engage, and the human forms capitalism only an inclusion of control that Zulu, and a wealthy and disorder the double and the capitalist imperialism and the imperial machine, and it's time for every human being yourself, so we have to be outside the globe, close capital, we must take this for power negative terms to the exclusive purposes, and this society control of globalizing apparatus, and it's fine, with a more general, more democratic human order, the imminent field, our protests not simply resist the parliament, to reorganize them, and redirect them towards new ends, cut in, add ins, and also, we turn this argument, Jason, Bartolo, may have been, but indicates that graffiti has been a method for anti-capitalist revolutions to spread the message, which sets up the permutation used when he sees the method as a means of spreading the revolution. There is no reason as why these why we can't do the graffiti and engage in violence we would benefit if the revolution alone is worth this. We must rethink the way that boogers are formally in this task, where we would infinitely repeat the oppression of Hitler and Mussolini, this Jules Marty, 95. No revolution may continue to exist, assume the need for service and organization to permit the masses to take root choice of their desire. The political organization function on the bottom line always see the same progressive results. This one machine that produces revolutionary energy. And the one finds a new top structure that moves to the fusion of collective sorrow and organization or some continues to the press map and going from oppression to repression. And that if it now is the essential time to embrace the politics and nomadism, the oppressions of the global capitalist spirit are coming. And no more loose American press, we must not question the future of revolution. Up in this politics, that's what was part of 87. Essentially, capitalism holds to the more muscle they say no one exists. This was with the widow. It's not really well known for us, like the police and no business that's happening. It's not a safe one, the lines of the line between the market and outdoors. It's a big one, the revolution, the correlation, and of course, possibly coming on to the argument. One would only disarm that we are not a perfect human expression. We're not just a form of discourse, we're rather an endorsement. Graffiti is a political method for any sort of being an individual that should be able to. To use this, we never deny sort of animals or any other objects the ability to do graffiti, which is anyone who should do it. This sets up the permutation to bend the reason we can't see all objects on a form of flat ontology and do graffiti. So we don't see things in a total hierarchization. We actually break this hierarchization down. That was the case. That was the case. So they also, you have to recognize your position. You have to go out because you're not one. So we should go as our agency.
I really couldn't hear that last argument. We start cross X with
sure.
What that was.
Okay. It was just we should use our own agency.
Okay.
You should not think like an object because you are not one. Or rather use your sort of agency to break down those sort of hierarchies.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm cool with it.
Yeah.
Alright. So let's start with the case debate.
Sure.
You made an argument that graffiti gives individuals agency.
Yeah.
What cardinal honesty do you think makes that claim?
Almost everyone, specific to graffiti, a version swallowing evidence, the second piece of version swallowing evidence. The Bartolomeo evidence gives historical examples.
Okay, yeah, let's talk about those historical examples
sure.
Real quick. I read through it during your speech.
Yeah, sure.
It cites movements of groups of people in Papua New Guinea and in Paraguay,
yeah, sure.
I believe.
Yeah.
Can you point to me a part of that card, highlighted or unhighlighted, that says that it can give individuals, not part of a movement, individuals
the voice of the common man.
It's
more political resistance.
It supports the common man, but all of the movements that it cites
okay.
are groups
yeah.
of people
get,
working towards a collective group.
I get what you're saying, but I still think the Bartolomeo card's good. But also the Giller evidence.
Oh, no, yeah.
I'll quote
the Giller. In an exclusionary system, the experience of living under is not one of choice. For marginalized groups are can serve as a source of identity and power. Art is able to give a voice to empower those who have been
Seems their references, graffiti is a force of
art
marginalized groups.
Graffiti is able to give a voice to empower those who have been silenced. Seems pretty.
In the 1970s, development of graffiti gave New York City's African-American and Puerto Rican urban youth.
Okay, yeah, I get what you're saying, but what I'm getting at is that all of these seem to be supporting the resistance of a group of people
yeah.
towards the state.
It is literally a source of agency.
I mean, all of those examples said graffiti is a form of resistance for marginalized groups, and graffiti is a form of resistance for African-American
We don't think that the Gillard evidence indicates that in the 1970s, African-American Puerto Rican youth in New York would use graffiti. We don't think that those people were a collective sort of political movement, rather that they were a type of population that would utilize this because it was a trend, not that they were in a collective
politic.
So if all of these people became part of this this trend to resist the state through through graffiti, what's the end point to this resistance?
There is no end point. That's the last D&G card. It says politics is always flung upon us. We are a middle point. We are our starting point because we are already engaging in politics. We are not a predecessor to our end point because that would have a theological view of the political that would sort of cut off our ability for to engage.
Okay, so if
you
don't describe an endpoint, then what in the status quo do you want to break down?
It's not a question, it's the way the state apparatus operates and creates spaces of interiority. Our form of nomadic politics is in opposition to that sort of a principle of organization and is able to break it down by
adhering
to the sort of lines.
We also break down the theological view of infrastructure that's only utility. We talked about that a little bit in the first process.
No prep. The order is framework and then the object kit.
Whoa.
Oh no. Oh, man. Oh.
Sorry. Yeah. Are you speaking from over here? I guess.
I can speak wherever you want.
I think over here works pretty well. I'm gonna put this stuff.
Will accept the investment violation. You have to spend money. That's the only predictable way for us to get offense on the topic because it's a topic about investment, not about infrastructure. You have just asserted that investment includes time spent in doing the graffiti, but you have no evidence on this question, and our evidence is definitive that you must spend capital to be able to consider an investment. Here's more evidence on that. Becker aid. Then a distinction was made between government expenditure, capital expenditure on infrastructure projects such as transport, capital expenditures regularly labeled as investment. The problem is the broad definition of investment, and this doesn't mean that we linked any of their offense. You get to have your discussion of any of the critical apps, and you don't have to identify with the state, but you must remain within the realm of investment. Their arguments about fairness being constantly evolving doesn't mean we should try to preserve some predictability for the neg. It's the only way for us to have a stable ground to negate them, and it's an independent violation that they have no evidence and no offense on.
Go to the critique.
We do not have an accuracy statement for a different way to do the world, but rather an alternate frame to look at the world as it is. The lens of the flat ontology, the acknowledgement that everything that is an object and cannot be reduced to anything else. This logically leads us to vote negative. The 1AC's project is a reductionist understanding that paints the world as objects that only have meaning when they are infused with the creativity of human art and graffiti, which forgets the world of objects themselves and only sees them in the way that we can relate to them. It's a question of starting points, and flat ontology cannot be from the strategy of the 1AC. This outweighs the case. It's the most open form of being. It's the only strategy that is open to ethics. There's no reason to exclude objects from our world except for self-referential arguments about human betterness. Only our flat ontology is a strategy that acknowledges others. They build the primacy of the human enterprise and the millions of objects and animals that have become a standing reserve for human goals. It ensures extinction in a world where we are all interconnected. That's our Bryant evidence. They've conceded the critique is a solvency deficit and a case turn. This card's like a minute long and they have no answer. The burden of proof is on them to prove that their focus on the discursive world of expression can change anything about the material world of capitalism that we live in. Our final piece of Brian evidence said they have the wrong starting point. The systems of the world are not no longer supported by theoretical ideologies that float around. They are sustained by objects. They are trapped in the university analyzing the discourse impacts of graffiti. Only our focus on the world of objects provides an impetus for 21st century politics. Pretending that these signifiers do anything in the world is wrong, and it also creates failures. This criticism cannot change anything. Bryant 12, correlationism has noxious political consequences. Man has been flattened to a blank slate for human destruction. Correlation then trains us to see all material things as what are things for us. This analysis renders invisible the differences contributed by non-human objects and social assemblages. We come to think that if we want to change social assemblages, all we have to do is critique and debunk ideologies. We critique and debunk, and the social system doesn't change. Correlationism tends to render non-signifying social assemblages inevitable. Points to expand sites of political acting. We cannot effectively change things if we don't know how assemblages are put together. Now, they say that there's no link because they are not saying human expression is good. Yes, you are. That is the whole 1AC, that art, aesthetics, expression, and agency makes the creativity that is beautiful about human life. But that is also a link argument, because this humanism that celebrates the inherent creativity of humanity means that we do not like that which is boring and simply an object in and of itself. This permutation is severance, because the 1AC clearly stated that their method of expression through art came first and had exclusive focus on it. This makes the world of objects invisible. They can't take back what the 1AC said, because critique apps are already fairly shifty and hard to debate. Stick them to the 1AC. It's our only basis for a next strategy, and it's sequencing this ad. Making the object a footnote is bad, because we must focus on objects, because currently there is no discussion of them. Bryant 12, if there is currently a focus on non-human entities, then this is because signification currently hegemonizes cultural studies in the humanities. It is necessary to bring other things into relief. We have so many links to the 1AC that they cannot go for the permutation. First is aesthetics. Celebrating human art as beautiful means that it separates us from the world of objects, which is not an expression of human creativity, and it also means that we make aesthetic judgments about what counts as valuable and what counts as beautiful, which means we can destroy that as which is ugly. We might save the cute polar bears, but destroy the slug, because we simply don't care. This is a link to the creative strategy of the 1AC that calls for an embrace of agency and radical freedom. Bell and Russell 2K. Humans alone are self-conscious. Humans alone infuse the world with their creative presence. Freire represents other animals in terms of their lacks of such traits. Thus, humans inhabit a world where they create and transform. For animals, there's only habitat, a mere physical space to which they are organically bound. The service of human freedom is seen to be our primary agenda. Humans are cast as active agents whose very essence is to transform the world. Human-animal opposition is taken for granted, and therein lies the problem. This becomes normal way of seeing the world. The primacy of the human enterprise is simply not questioned. There's seldom mention of the non-human. Anthropocentrism passes unchallenged. There's also a link to their empowerment claims about bringing voices and agency, because this is merely built on the backs of the oppression of everything that isn't human. Bell and Russell 2K. Educators would do well to draw on the misguided sense of independence premised on freedom from nature that informs notions as empowerment. Critical pedagogy challenges education whose sole aim is the development of the individual mind. Also, their entire app is a link. The thesis of graffiti is that for objects to be valuable, they need human intervention to paint graffiti on them. They're not content with the train car as it is. They are content with the train car as they decide to paint on it. This denies the independence of the world of objects and means that we only see them as how we can relate to them, what we can do to them, and what we don't want to do to them. There also is a link. The last card of the 1AC talks about playing around with ideology as a strategy. This is a pretty luxurious position, to be able to sit around and play with discourses. It is built on the destruction of every other object that is not a human one. Also, you are just painting pretty pictures on structures of the subjugation of the natural world. Trains might look cooler after you paint on them, but they still emit and destroy the entire world. Additionally, graffiti leads to aerosol emissions that destroy the environment. Lesky 10. VOCs are precursors of ozone. Since emissions related to graffiti are VOC-based, they contributed to the formation of ground-level ozone. Graffiti sector emissions were approximately 31 tons of emissions. 4,862 tons of emissions were emitted from the graffiti sector. Graffiti emissions were greater than non-void sectors. Obvious link, because they don't care about anything that doesn't threaten our creativity and allows us to destroy the environment for us to play our little games with pictures. They say the flat ontology is not mutually exclusive. We don't need to win mutual exclusivity. We need to win links to the 1AC, which prove disadvantages to including the affirmative. They've also conceded that the alternative solves the whole case, so there is no net benefit to including the affirmative. Also, they say they break down hierarchies. Yeah, you might break down the tiny hierarchy of capitalism, but you are leaving so many others unchallenged that you will not access an impact at the end of this round. They say you should use your agency because you are not an object. First off, agency is a link. Our Bell evidence indicates that when you try to affirm human agency, it means you can never engage in the world of things that do not have agency. Also, even if you are not an object, ontology requires you to step out of yourself to see other forms of ethics. Also, you conceded what flat ontology means, is that everything is an object. It's just that you focus on human objects instead of non-human objects. And even if they try to win any of their claims about art from a cosmic point of view, the universe doesn't really need us. Lee 99. We should not delude ourselves that humanization will stop a planet Earth. Other planets may be humanized, while other planets may not have life on them. This does not render them only of instrumental value. Nature, whether biotic or abiotic, is ontologically independent. We have failed to recognize that nature embodies its own value. It is not true that nature is devoid of all value, and the values are projections of human attitudes upon nature. It would be fallacious to conclude that human consciousness is the source of all values. Human consciousness does not generate value. Nature's value exists whether humankind is around or not. Everything has intrinsic value. It doesn't need graffiti. Merchant 92. Each individual thing, whether a living organism is animate, has intrinsic value. Proponents recognize the interconnection between organisms and environments. We are diminished not only by the peasant, but the slaughter of whales and porpoises and the harvesting of red roots. We are diminished when technology turns grassland into deserts. Rocks have intrinsic value. This could provide an environmental lesson. I should mark it.
Alright, first question. You present impacts such as like transportation kills the environment, capitalism, other hierarchies. What is the alternative affirmation of flat ontology do to solve those sort of hierarchies and like tangible sort of oppression?
What do you mean?
How does the alt solve impacts like environmental destruction?
Okay, so the impact is not necessarily environmental destruction in the sense.
What's that part about like transportation infrastructure kills the environment?
That card says that aerosol emissions from graffiti hurt the environment. The argument is not necessarily like you destroy the environment so badly that there's going to be an impact. It's about the fact that you can justify destruction of the environment as long as you get to do your little creative projects because you view those side effects of your actions as relatively unimportant.
Okay, that's fine. How does the alternative solve the case?
The alternative
solves
yeah,
the case. Like
sure.
What part of the case does it solve?
Our evidence indicates that focusing on a material world of objects rather than the world of expression, signifiers, floating ideologies.
Wait, how is graffiti not the sort of like material action that can create symbolic and material change?
Right. It can be a material action, maybe, but
maybe.
That is
that's
not the one AC.
That's what it
that
is
not the one AC. You have expressed it
as
a site of
how is
human
the one
creativity.
How? We describe it as a place for politics where people can create material and symbolic change. I'm just curious as to how like we're caught up in the world of like,
okay.
Ideology.
Our argument about the alternative solving the case is not that the alt does graffiti. Our argument about the alternative solving the case is that our alternative provides a different politics that is better able to deal with things like hierarchies, territorialization, and capitalism. Our Bryant evidence specifically cites working against capitalism as requiring a focus on objects.
Okay.
Why? Our evidence indicates that the structures of capitalism have become a hyper object. They are no longer sustained by ideologies. They are sustained by material objects that provide for the flows of commerce that your Deleuze evidence is so.
How are those material? How is that material commerce upheld? It's through ideology, right?
Nope. I wouldn't agree.
You wouldn't say
that
the desire for capital expenditure is what upholds these material aspects of capital?
I would say that the material aspects of capital are held up by the material
the
structures that allow them to happen.
Those sort of material aspects.
I mean,
what causes people to do one thing?
The critique doesn't attempt to answer the question of why there is a capitalist system. It attempts to answer the question of what that capitalist system is and how we can react
that's fair.
To it.
You read this piece of Bell evidence, which is like your link to agency. Can you just explain that?
Yeah, our argument is that human agency, which the 1AC is predicated off of,
how do we deny the agency of like other like objects?
That's not our argument. It's that giving humans unbridled agency is authorization.
It's not what we're all about.
Okay. Your last card, the Deleuze evidence, is all about affirming the agency within the round that the judge has to. I don't know. I thought that was about agency.
Okay.
No one in our breath, I'm assuming.
No.
Where is my stance?
Can I just speak on the.
I'm just standing here. Yeah,
I can lose ours.
It's just the case debate.
Okay. All right. Second and front. Keenan, can you kick them out? Okay. 2 seconds.
Oh, sure.
So now in case.
Yep.
Okay.
Mao can't concede the permutation dissonance competition. Don't let them update it now on case at the top. They have conceded two important arguments. First, they concede that nomadic resistance is inevitably co-opted by capitalism. That means that the framework under which the firm operates will inevitably co-opted by the structures that they attempt to break down, which means that first they can never break they can't break down a friction or the heels of transportation infrastructure because capitalist police will inevitably use it to control movements in the way that one that means that there's no risk that the abstract framework is able to solve. Also means that a risk of a reservoir diagonal coloniality turns means you vote negative because we have a risk that they increase oppression and they have no way of breaking down oppression. Furthermore, complacent with colonialism and Eurocentrism makes violence inevitable. We don't propose an alternative, but choosing to tie oneself to a colonialist attitude is sufficient to challenge the dominant their dominant epistemology that only Julian criticism is able to solve. Mondo Torres 6. The problem with the search for truth is it gives the movement of an epistemic establishes the movement of dominant critique without the reconciliation between different channels at a personal and institutional level. The point of the question of dominant epistemic creates a different form of understanding of the world. The fundamental changes within the subject of knowledge and down to the question of a different expression of epistemic decolonial attitude and different opposition from a decolonization and different effort and a pair of social rift with an ethics where such a movement is truth telling and never again along with another board of possible and its fundamental aspect of organism and such as university never brought decolonization with different effects of coloniality. There can be no reconciliation with different unforgotten alternatives of the nation state, modernity, and liberal democracy. The idea of giving an economy responsibility to different generosity produce ideals of leadership and intellectual law, decolonial, post-colonial economy, and Europe, breaking down the categories that accept and maintain power. Now, the decoloniality trend, the app form of resistance is to endorse an idea of providing smooth space through graffiti, but that is never co-opted by the military. They didn't adequately answer our one and see Marno episode, which cites an example where the Israeli military teaches students of high school anti-Oedipus so that when they join the Israeli National Army, they take that idea for breaking down walls and constructing and instructing of Palestine as a form of oppression to be broken down. They say that they don't take a teleological stance on what forms of oppression they break down, which means that they're not able to avoid them being co-opted by these forms of oppression. They cannot say that they say in response to this argument that they are their evidence says that graffiti is inherently anti-capitalist and that they will break down the military, but they cannot make these claims because they can't make a claim that they necessarily break down these structures. Also, they can see that the state can change individuals' minds about what forms of oppression they resist, which means that they will not resist forms of oppression that they actually want to resist. And furthermore, DJ's vision of the world is inaccurate. Their Eurocentrism and epistemological neutral discourse and that forms non-Europeans as expendable. That turns case Marno in 99. When they come to speech that the forms of white claim themselves non-white, they recognize the other within each non-situation which signs are seen through the white speaking to be designated as a non-white person who is saying that language is one white speaking speak to nothing but a non-white extent that they both identify themselves as white and they produce each other to the other meaning for example and the non-white person is ironically this is especially about the whiteness of being within the language of racism existing comes within a full group of speak leading existence of protection is of a right for the race to reach a existence within the use of language and those who are not the language they say that they give minorities a voice but across they can't point to an example in which they give individual minorities a voice. It's just part of overall groups. And each example each example of resistance comes from a colonialized country where graffiti was never actually able to give individual agency. Like in Paraguay, this proves that graffiti just commodified and forced the graffiti artists to be re-educated into art and charges that serve the terms of the state. This is essentially a status quo proves that it proves the case doesn't solve argument because graffiti exists in the status quo and doesn't adequately resist oppression, they won't be able to solve. They're going to try to say that the loses war machine arguments outweigh the term, but their war machine notion is too abstract. They have an interaction for real politics and dominant war rooms, Howard and Six. Deleuze can lose the objectification and not worth while because their objectification shows the question is not the real question. Deleuze's question is the best available question because there's no available in Deleuze's philosophy of any notion of actual world. Deleuze can obviously be reasonable to think about the question of actual world and then worth the Deleuze's response to the actual virtual war machine.
How much time do we have?
Can I get a pen?
Can I have that last Olive card you read?
Yeah.
I marked it.
Hey, y'all got time right now?
Yeah.
Okay. Just step outside.
Thank you.
They've conceived the role about that you should vote for the best political strategy to win in your agency. Their form of investment is inaccessible to populations. Not everyone can spend money to build a train, but everyone can access graffiti, which means all of our offense are still dissatisfied with their interpretation. One, he said the response on dissatisfied evidence indicates that focusing on transcendent politics, like what the United States federal government should do, sees your agency is not something we affirm. This causes internalization or slave ontology, because you never see yourself as good enough in the world. We should affirm the agency within our choices, because graffiti is responsible for all of us. That'll be on the case of being B as a homogenization, just that our offered evidence indicates, and when you have a theological view of what transportation infrastructure investment causes a modernization of the way we debate it, that the impact is two things. One, debate becomes stale because we always argue about the same thing over and over, and B, they cause a violent explosion or of our form of debate, which means case that decided their interpretation. Also, they concede you default to reason, believe me, Daniel. Evidence indicates that loss of reasonability is good because it increases critical thinking. You have to think under feet. It's always something responsive. Debate creates a constraint on form, not content, which means we should be able to say what we want now. Not the case to make another argument or intrinsic to the affirmative. There's absolutely no internal link for housing. How using graffiti gets co-opted by the state. We solve all their co-option arguments. Our definition of a nomad is someone who is outside the state apparatus, who has never tries to include themselves. Nomadism only becomes co-opted when the state takes hold of it. Bar friction holding evidence indicates that when we cast the graffiti artist as a nomad form of representation is necessarily outside the state, is able to disrupt the way that graffiti is used, or that transportation is used as only a point of utility. Now, their next argument is the decolonialism dissenter Gilbert evidence is burning on fire on this question. Indicates that using graffiti as a medium for expression is able to give individuals without a voice as a culture. It indicates that gives empirical examples how teenagers in the 1970s in New York would use graffiti as a medium for expression, allow them to give them a voice in the form of representation. Now, their next argument is that the state is able to solve extend the D&G evidence. We ought to write with symbols. We are thrown into the world. There is no starting point. Politics is already sedentary. The only thing that we must ask ourselves is graffiti a good medium now? Just because people misread Deleuze in Israel does not mean that graffiti is not a good form of representation. We should not censor our politics because of it, because we are not responsible for those things. Now, their next argument is that the idea of the war machine is too broad. Our evidence is more specific, and they think they're not engaging the hyper-specificity of casting the graffiti art as a form of the war machine. Which means you probably shouldn't evaluate this argument. Now, go to the Malkay damning concession. They conceded the 2AC Zala evidence indicates that challenges to capitalism are moot unless we engage in the form of collective desire. There is no it's in capitalism. 2AC Zala evidence indicates that there's no center from which capitalism flows. Rather, it's created and reinforced every day through our personal lives. The material aspects of capitalism only exist because people's desire for capital expenditure, and only an affirmation which engages on the level of desire, like the affirmative, can solve for these things. That is a reason why you're going to prefer the vehicle permutation. Now, go to on objects oriented ontology. Now, they can see the rules about that you focus on the best politics that are within your agency. We have two dissatisfied with the alternative. A is the Smith evidence. It indicates that they are a form of responsibility. They do not see their agency as something to be affirmed. Rather, they are transcendent to all other objects. We are not responsible for the violence that goes on because of the capitalist system. We should not hold ourselves responsible for that, because it turns, it allows for an internalization of that violence when we see ourselves as complicit. And B is the that is also the D&G evidence. We are not a starting point in history. Rather, we are thrown into a sedentary form of politics. Not the question should not be about the past, about hierarchy. Rather, it should be about what we can do, because the only thing we can control. Now, we have a couple of link turns to their argument A, crossed by the Zawa evidence, only engaging on the level of desire, is able to break down the way that capitalism manifests itself in material structures. Material structures do not hold up. Material structures doesn't even make sense. The desire for capitalism is what allows capitalism to perpetuate itself. Now, the Frazier and Spalding evidence from the second piece of Frazier and Spalding evidence from the 2AC is a solvency advocate for vehicle permutation, that we should use the method of the 1AC to spread the message of the alternative. We wrote on the whiteboard, people cannot know about flat ontology unless they are told about it through symbols. The reading of the 1NC was a discursive symbol that spread the message of flat ontology. The permutation is also that. Also, it makes a unique winter to their argument that the transportation infrastructure is held as a teleological view for capital accumulation in the status quo. Like all of their art arguments that they make, that we only see art as we only see types of art as value, but that's not true. Our evidence indicates that we should disrupt that canonization and that control of space through a process of expression that only individuals can have. Now, their next argument is that humans aren't key to the universe. That is not our argument. The idea that you hold us to a human center on ontology probably puts you linked to their own argument. They do not know what graffiti is, and bird pooping on a Corvette is probably a form of graffiti. It's just all about the way we express those things. You can take the view of a
it's a flat-centered ontology through the message of the app.
Okay, bro.
Is it cool if I run to the restroom?
No.
I'm a nomad, so...
framework flow, top, then Mao, then the K. The K does have an overview component.
You said framework, Mao, object oriented ontology?
Yes, sir.
Cool.
In order. Everyone ready? Mind if I shut this door?
Oh, no.
We'll concede their title, don't vote against us because we excluded them, because we're letting them in the debate now. We're the Mao K. The alternative solves all of capitalism. That will be on their achievement aid, which means they can't leverage an external impact. There's also no impact. They've conceded that capitalism is relatively minor of our hierarchy compared to the subject object dichotomy, which forms the basis of all of the oppression of the K. They don't even extend an impact to capitalism in the one hour, which means that this link turn is relatively useless for them in the debate, when the critique will always outweigh the case. Go to the critique. Flat ontology is key to openness of ethics, which is allowing us to respect non-human entities. If we win, any risk that the 1AC is a project that is founded on your respect for humanism above other forms of existence, then you vote negative because it is an unethical form of existence. The Lee evidence is an impact framing question that says that from a cosmic perspective, the universe simply does not need human beings. This means they don't get to leverage their offensive of the value of human agency or human creativity, because we are not needed to make the universe valuable, because objects are ontologically independent and possess their own intrinsic value, which means that any risk that they exclude them from your calculations or the way that you see the world is a reason to vote negative. This is the only independent impact that they cannot access because it was never part of the case. But we also turn case our current evidence dedicated to focusing on the material world of structures allows us to combat capitalism, even if it's not as good as their desire. Because there's no question of sufficiency framing, which means that if we are able to combat capitalism, we solve some of the case, which is enough to vote on our independent impact of open ethics.
Now, the line by line.
He says the role of the ballot is to occupy politics within your agency. First off, we have made the argument that you are an object. All humans are objects, which means that you are not stepping outside of your agency. Also, you must step outside of pure humanism in order to solve the critique, because you have to identify with things that are not of yourself to have open ethics. That's our impact argument. And it's also a link, because agency prioritizes the centrality of the human enterprise. They say horizontal, but this had new. The 2AC made no efforts on the critique, just stumbled out a couple analytics and a permutation, which means you should regard this with heavy skepticism. He doesn't tie it to a piece of evidence, which means the 2AR doesn't get to do that. There's also no link, because there is meaning in living with harmony with objects. It doesn't destroy our value of life. There's also no impact. Who cares if we have a negative opinion of ourselves? Structures of oppression of non-human existence are much, much, much more important than how you feel at the end of the day, because they create actual destruction of things that matter. Your emotions are relatively insignificant. Also, they say that they shouldn't be held responsible for violence that they're not directly responsible for. You are responsible. You have conceded our emissions link, which will be on the permutation to make it a proof that you are directly increasing the destruction of objects and the non-human others in the status quo. They say desire evidence is a link to it. First off, desire doesn't come first. It's impossible to know the desire of objects, which means that it fundamentally limits our considerations and it is inherently exclusionary. What is the desire of a train car? Is it to be painted on? We do not know, which means that the framework of desire limits us to talking exclusively about subjects, and specifically the human subject, which means that we'll never be able to access any solvency of our alternative or solve the impact. It's also a proof to another link argument. They say that we solve using the method of the 1AC. Cool, you wrote on a whiteboard. That does not give it more meaning than a blank whiteboard. To prove this, they no longer solve the alternative. That means that your strategy is fundamentally impermanent. You are unable to create any form of lasting ethics, because all you care about is playing around with signs and signifiers, but never actually engaging in one specific strategy. We have a link to your method. If you want to use the method of the 1AC to solve the alternative, that is impossible. Our evidence indicates that creativity, which is the method of the 1AC to endorse human agency, is a link to our argument. They say that the 1AC reads words. This is a wash, because both teams are reading words, which means it's not a reason to vote affirmative. It's also a new argument, and what we say matters. It's not the mere fact that you talked is our link. It's what you talked about and why you prioritize human expression. They say permutation do both. This is their last argument, and everything I said above proves that the permutation is pretty much impossible. We have several links that are conceded That means you should go negative. Our Bryant evidence was conceded as a sequencing this that says you must start from the position of the object. If we win any risk that they include subjects or expression, you vote negative because bringing both into cultural studies allows us to homogeneously focus on these subjects. Only a focus on objects is sufficient to solve. There's also no net benefit to including the app because they've conceded we solved the whole case. Our link arguments are simple. First law is aerosol emissions. You don't care about the consequences of your action on anyone but humans. You care about your little games that are pretty pictures on planes, which create these structures of oppression just looking a little bit nicer, but you are literally destroying things that are not human. Creativity is a link. Our Bell and Russell love that says creativity is founded on a human enterprise and celebrates our ability to mark the world with our symbols, our paintings, and our designs. This is a link because it prioritizes the creativity of humanity. It also turns your raison d'etre back because you hate the world as it is and want a new one that is more creative and exciting. The final argument is you only think that objects are valuable when it's graffitied on. Yeah, a train is an object, no duh, but you only think it has value when we infuse the signs of human expression on it by graffitiing it. An empty whiteboard is the same as a blank whiteboard, and a blank train is the same as a graffiti train. Prioritizing one over the other is a hierarchy.
Our role is that you should work the best political strategy facing your agency. We have a couple of dissats to the alternative. We have a couple of dissats to the presentation. As well as the alternative views, the one you see as a means of expression. The alternative to flat ontology is not exclusive with the one you see. To put their primates, it says flat ontology signifies not ontology. And of course, there is one ontological type of individuals. This seems to be pretty clear with our role about, which is that you should endorse the best political strategy for individuals. We have a couple of dissats. First is the response is that the alternative is a focus on transcendence that is something far removed from your agency. That idea that we are responsible for the equality of every greater than being the universe. It's an ontological condition of lockdown because we hate ourselves. We hate the fact that we have power and others don't. What about the voices that so many have been denied? How do you solve for that? Is there an event of variation as well as the solvency that they don't have a form to make this first themselves? The alternative would prefer that we ignore those in favor of a challenge the life and attempt to change the minds of everyone around us. You cannot help some people view life through a hierarchy. What you can do is grab a bottle of spray paint and go write about how messed up that is through the expression of the variation. You accomplish the same message, but you allow for your own impression, own expression, which why agencies and benefits of the variation is something they can never solve for. And B is like writing simple states that the argument is that the universe doesn't need humanism, nor is that we do not choose how we come into the world. This is the last piece of DNA evidence that says we are thrown in the world of politics, which means it's the question of how we engage in the political. And should we just sit behind and be passive subjects, or should we try to do something on the material level that can actually sort of change the way these hierarchies situate themselves? Seeing everything on a blend of ontology does nothing to actually change the problem. Risk of graffiti being a good political method is a reason as to why you go to affirmative and even another is that a symbolic dissenter focus when only the material forms of oppression ignores the way that oppressive systems like capitalism operate. This is the Zulu evidence that says hierarchies like capitalism are non-monolithic entities which sort of act upon us rather than being created and reinforced by our desire for consumption and domination, which is something that only we account for. They say you should know it and only focus on the material, but this is never able to solve the problem. It just allows for this sort of hierarchies to reassert themselves. We have to attack the very root of the problem, which is why we desire sort of consumptive practices in the first place, which is going to be a key framing issue in terms of solvency.